Go ahead. Whatever you ready. No. Something. Whatever they ready, you ready.
DJ. I gave you a CD.
See?
Etta James, track 2. Where's Etta?
You feel my pain, Miss Jackie, right?
I feel more than pain right now.
Come on, Al.
Well, as always, I said track 2. Track 2. Yes!
I get a good feeling.
The goofball here, the one that's bald-headed, non-speaking, called me about 2 weeks ago and said, Miss Jackie, would you please come to Southern Comfort and entertain the folks a little bit? And due to the fact, because I'm from the South, as you can tell by my accent, I just love to be any goddamn where that got anything to do with the South.
Alright.
So, I ain't gonna keep y'all too long, cause, well, the gentleman I came with tonight, that's Mr. George. That's the one I be on stage popping bullshit about. And I hate to tell you this, honey, but just because you here live, I'm still gonna pop bullshit about you tonight.
Alright.
Anyway, and once again, I'm here with my two lovely female friends in comedy, Monique and Michelle, back there in the back. Yes, give up for my girl. But the first time I met them two, I fell in love with them. And I told them that Miss Jackie got 2 dreams. Me and them two, we gonna get to Madison Square Gardens.
Right.
And the next one is, we are going to Sydney, Australia, to the Sydney Opera House to do a show. I don't know how the hell we gonna get there, but the man upstairs gonna make it possible. But anyway, you know, a lot of people ask me, Miss Jackie, my comedy is a little different. I tell stories and I try to make them funny as possible. Do you mind if I come down off stage? Thank you. Don't you feel this killing me? I wear these shoes when Mr. George gonna get some. I got them on my feet. But anyway, for why this started, I want every woman in this room to raise up her hand. From the bartender, I don't care how old your coochie is, just raise up your hand. If your coochie ain't 5, raise it up. I want every woman in this room, on the count of motherfucking 3, if you got good coochie, give your shit a round of applause. I know I said it was Thursday night, and I said I was not going to talk about coochie.
Okay.
I wasn't going to talk, but then I said, fuck it, I'm Miss Jackie.
Right.
I got to be me.
Okay.
One of my girlfriends asked me, because I got 3 kids. And my girlfriend asked me on the job, Miss Jackie, don't you want grandchildren? I said, hell no, bitch, I smoke too much weed. I don't want no grandkids. No, that's meant no grandkids but fucking my weed smoking time. I told my daughter, y'all come to, I get fucked up on the weekend, y'all come to my house, then the motherfuckers be tied to the tree in the back, goddamn y'all. No, you smoke weed, you don't need no kids. No. Cause see, like I said, I grew up down south. Everybody, did y'all have that grandmama, when your mama took your ass on the weekend, and she give your ass that NyQuil, and keep your ass sleep all goddamn day long, and your mama could come pick your ass up. Damn, Junior still napping, and damn, mama, I dropped him off here at 7 o'clock, this motherfucker still sleep. Damn, bitch ass, he don't bitch get your ass NyQuil. That way grandma could watch her story, got him on the phone, and bring her gin. I'm sorry, no, I don't know kids, don't grandkids, no, like I said, that's fucking my weed smoking time, no. And besides, I don't like you in no way. Ain't no biting disease, can't, I got 3 kids, I can't stand them, no bastards. No, I'm sorry, no, I told my girl, y'all get mine, stay on birth control, as long as possible. The only time I want to be a grandmama is when I'm 105 and I'm on my way to die. That's it. But I swear, I love to see all these black people in one place. The last time I was at a place, it was so empty. That was like, nigga, that place was about empty, and niggas at a Klan funeral.
Oh.
I ain't lying. I mean, that place was empty. And I told Double D, I said, Double D, you know I'm old. I don't like to do shit till the weekend. If I come to this motherfucker and it's empty, I'm going to whoop your ass in the parking lot. I'm going to beat your ass white.
In the parking lot.
I ain't lying, girl. A lot of people ask me, Jackie, why you so mean? And I'm going to tell y'all something. It's not that I'm mean. I just don't like stupid people. I mean, you know, a lot of times you look at the news and you see women on, especially women are always the victim. And I guess I do stir most of my comedy towards women because women go through hell.
Yeah.
We do hell. And every time I turn around, some poor woman getting grabbed by some rapist, pulling some poor woman drawers off, taking her shit when she ain't gave it to the motherfucker. And you know, and I tell anybody, no, don't get me wrong. Miss Jackie likes to give a little head once in a while. But that's when Miss Jackie's permission. Because I tell you, you break the fuck in my house and put your shit in my mouth without my permission, I'm going to bite your dick right off, motherfucker. I'm going to bite your shit off. I will bite your shit off and call the popo and tell him that, come, what happened to his dick? I bit that shit off. Now I'm taking dickless ass out of my house and his balls with him. Because I'm telling you, you know, I'm sorry, I'm 51 years old. And this year coming, I'll be 52. And I've been through too much hell and hot water in my life. Because see, after 12 midnight, I got 2 roommates, Smith and Wesson. You come the fuck in my house, I will introduce you to them. Don't come in my house, but I'll kick your ass, I'll fuck you up, you look worse than Tupac. Don't come the fuck in my house, don't do that. Don't do that to your mama. Don't even do that to yourself, and I will kill you. I ain't lying, and I'll go for the judge, and I ain't gonna take the fifth. Why did you do that? Because he came in my house, and I fucked him up. That's it. Bitch, I got a doorbell ringing.
Right.
Ding dong, bitch is dead. Oh, God, I cracked myself up. Or either that, oh, I'm serious, I do. Well, anyway, like I was saying, because see, I guess because being from down south and being a southern woman, I guess we just look at life differently. I mean, you know, but sometimes you have to look at life. I mean, well, not really. Well, anyway, well, what I'm going to say is, just like on Monday morning, when you get on the bus, and you ever get on the bus, you gonna spend your weekend with your little girlfriend, you got your hair all nice and primed up, and this motherfucker get on the bus, and his breath smell like he been kissing the back end of a baboon's ass, and he go to speak, his stinking ass breath, and your whole Monday morning fucked up. Or perfume and shot the hell. Cause you got on the bus with stinging ass breath. And I don't mean no harm, but I guess because I grew up on a farm, and certain odors I can't take. And I know the summer is gone. I wasn't going to tell this story tonight, but this is actually like 75%, well, 80% maybe, of most of the shit I tell you is true. I was on the bus one August, high as hell. And you know when the heat hits you, not hard sometimes. This motherfucker got on the bus. This bitch was stinking, Lord Jesus. And he stunk so bad, the baby next to me started crying. And the thing about it, I understand that y'all, you know, all we've been poor, hell, I'm poor myself. But you can go to the dollar store and get some soap to wash your ass. And then you're a stinking bitch, and you're going to try to talk, get some coochie, and you smell, oh my God, that man smells so bad, they should have called the damn health department. I mean, you getting on the bus smelling like that, you got mushrooms growing in your ass, and you trying to talk, get your stinking ass off this bus.
Mushrooms growing
in your
ass.
I mean, that shit, I never smelled nothing that bad in my life. I mean, I went back to my patients, how I asked when you go, saying, okay, like I said, I know a whole of you got no money, but you can go to the dollar store, get some soap, mouthwash, please. When the summertime comes, it was over 100 goddamn degrees, wash your ass. It is not rocket science. You don't need to take a test. You don't need to get in the Harvard. Simple. Stinking ass, wash. Rub it up, soap it up, rinse it the fuck off. That's all the hell you got to do. Damn. I'm gonna put my breath away. Tell me that. Is it time for me to go? Balls out? Well, it's time for me to go. But I just want to leave y'all with a little word of wisdom. Life is very short. Live, laugh, and love. If you do those three things, your life will be absolutely wonderful. And that's Miss Jackie for this evening.
All right.